entering water.
I did tell you, the reporter is entering water. The cameraman is also entering the canoe. And our narrator all getting ready. No, two of you can sit together. Let me sit at this end so that I can be doing the video. Okay, wait, to you know they move. From Vivian, two of you go sit for me today. So I can stay here and be doing my video very well. It's moving, Oyo.
You come here and you sit here with me. No.
Guy, wait, to.
Okay, can you wait up now?
No, no,
so
no.
I can go with him.
Wait, is that I did not balance well?
Guy, you are moving. Hold on, I beg you.
He said, make two of them one place, make him there for the other place.
That's it.
I see the markings on the wall. It is at the roofing level.
So, man, you only see the roof.
Yes.
Like the ones inside there.
Yeah. Those ones inside there. You can see the roof, but these ones, the water got just to the roof. This mom must have been very, very serious.
Imagine, this is a street too.
Yeah. And then the police that this place is actually a road.
Mm-hmm. And a road.
That is well tarred.
Yes, with drainage.
Yeah, with drainage as well.
Hello, Kajon, Mago.
Why are you? My friend, I'm telling you.
You know, the problem is that I use the plan in London now. Go enter inside.
They just take the shot from here.
No, it's your place, sir.
Here, here. These two buildings.
I want to take the shot from
water. We're
not entering
inside.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So follow like
okay,
that.
Okay, see, they go front.
No, not the front. Like, just follow
okay,
here.
Okay, okay. Understand.
Yeah, so look, he's in this, this end like this.
On the good, never enjoy. I think the flood. I think the real good flood.
Not too close, so that the water can be showing the water.
Yeah.
Don't go too close.
Okay.
It's okay.
I got invited now.
Okay. Chere. Jirupa ya niko sicha.
Okay.
Like I go come with Amiri and go to the
yeah. No, get that now. Mariba.
Chere man.
Prince, you got it?
Yes. So we are going back now. No, let's start here. It's okay. Yeah. Yes. Yes, I'm getting a reflection.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I
have
talk to him now.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. All right. Our boat driver. This house behind used to be your house.
Yeah.
That is painted white.
Yeah.
And then all of this there used to be a third road, right?
Yeah.
So you mean that we are on top of a road now,
uh-huh,
that leads to your house,
uh-huh,
that's tied with drainages.
Uh-huh.
Can you tell us how this whole thing started?
The flood.
Yeah.
The flood just came.
What?
An emergency. We did not expect it to be on this way. It just came small till the area was filled and we were attacked. Both my stuff, the front building, that's my stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's the first one that the flood carried.
Okay.
Before entering to my building. And the flood pushed me away with my family. And we packed out.
Okay.
So that's the suffering that we are now. And no compensation, no nothing. We have been hearing that the government has paid a very big huge of money to flood disasters. But no one has reached us. So we don't know where we are going.
In this house now, it looks like an abandoned district. Were you able to, did you carry out all the properties inside that house?
Yes, we saw that.
Did you carry out the properties before the flood?
I carry a few of.
Let's go. They go somewhere.
I carry a few of the property. And left some was filled by water.
Go. No, we are going somewhere else now.
I love you.
So where are the rest of your family?
I rented house for them outside. When there is the flood,
have to find accommodation for them outside. I rent them outside. Now I'm living outside with my family. So that's what you are suffering. And no compensation, no nothing. Even they feel that all that was living in the camp was only the flood disaster, not knowing some of the people rented the house outside and take care of their home. So that is that.
So this incident that happened now.
Yeah.
Today is the first of
November.
November.
And up till now, you can see that the water is still covering the head. Because some people say that the water has dried up in their own area.
Yeah.
But here, up till today, 1st of November 2012, this water is still like this.
Still like this.
How do people survive now?
We are suffering now. We are only no food, no nothing. We are just suffering. But we are living outside, and the whole of the money we keep, we have finished. We have finished our money. And nowhere to get.
There were these farms here.
That
had fish farms.
Yes.
So now, what happened to those fish farms?
All the whole fish ponds, the flood has carried the whole fish, and they are now suffering. They are suffering now. The whole river was.
The fish farms were submerged.
Scattered all everywhere. And people were killing the fish pond fish. So that is that.
Yeah, now.
Even in some homes, they see fish in their homes.
Wow.
Fishes from those fish farms.
Yeah.
Yes, now many of my property was destroyed in the flood. Because when the thing is too much, we do not expect it. When it is too much, now we have to keep the ones that can be able to keep. And leave others and save our life.
But without that, if you say you want to carry all your properties, you may die inside. So we only carry the children and save their life and leave property. That's what we see. They are bathing, but they are small kids now. They don't know what they are bathing on. Because me as a matured man, when I enter inside this water, I get a lot of scratch in my body. So they are kids. They don't know what they are doing.
Even the school was flooded.
So
the primary school. The primary school where you have the camp.
Hey, last
the primary school where you have the model primary school office where you have the camp was under construction. So the people from the primary school were also going to the grammar school. We have the secondary school that is called Ebema Grammar School here. So, but when the Ebema Grammar School too was flooded, so it means that no school again, both for the secondary and for the primary pupils, all of them are all at home. Even the private school.
Who is here now?
What you see is one private school here.
My woman.
So
the name of the school is My Woman, nursery school.
And
the flood has carried the whole school.
So there are several of them, some of those primary schools.
We have just come back from our boat cruise to go and see for ourselves and to also get some interview while we were on the boat to see things. And we actually saw that the flood submerged some houses. Some fish farms within this area were also submerged in such a way that the fishes all left because the water level was above the pond, and this has caused so much loss to the people of Okwizi. Their kids are at home, once for primary and nursery school, just the same for those at the secondary level. For some people whose houses I've been able to dry up a little bit. They are trying to clean up to see if they can actually move back to their houses. At this point, I want to say thank you.